So this is Nathan Little, and the meteor is coming.
I'm done calling when you call me, when you call me, and I'm done. say when I walk in through the door. Sauce is splattered on the walls and bones spilled on the floor. Jake is running back and forth, working on his own, trying to get some orders out while blasting the remotes. Celery is out, can I get some on the line? Winked up onto the floor, there's wing juice in my eye. Waitress rang these in wrong, can I get them sweet and sour? Sorry, Kathy, those won't be up for another hour. Tickets ringing in, they're all hanging to the floor. People waiting for their tables lined up at the door. I just used my last plate, dishwasher, where are you? My fries are all filled up, there's nothing I can do. 30, 40, 50, 60 wings are going down. People come for wing night from all across the town. All the wings that you can eat, they're 50 cents a piece. I'm stuck here working wing night every fucking week. In the oven, but the timer wasn't on. Burgers going medium, but they look more like well done. Hot sauce on the side, now these have to be remade. 4 more hours till we close, I can't wait to get paid. Chicken on the grill, but the grill is cold as hell. Burgers in the window, Jake, ring the fucking bell. Savannah wants to know if she can get these any faster. Tough luck, baby, we all know that wing night's a disaster. Tickets ring me in, they're all hanging to the floor. People waiting for their tables lined up at the door. Use my last plate, dishwasher, where are you? My fries are all filled up, there's nothing I can do. 30, 40, 50, 60 wings are going down. People come for wing night from all across the town. All the wings that you can eat, they're 50 cents a piece. I'm stuck here working wing night every fucking week. 30, 40, 50, 60 wings are going down. People come for wing night from all across the town. All the wings that you can eat, they're 50 cents a piece. I'm stuck here working wing night every fucking week. We'll be right back.
if you're a lost star in a band, if that's alright. Please don't care to seek a guide. So while you're losing your mind, won't you make some use of it? We'll think it through. Wouldn't it be nice if you just try and understand? I don't know what books you read. I don't care why you feel free. I don't know if you've been right or wrong. And I don't care where you belong. So while you're hanging around, won't you make some use of it? Try and understand. In the morning they woke flat on the floor, so their book wasn't aimed at anyone. Still they got shown the door. I don't know what place you're going to. I don't know what you've been through. But I don't even want to know your name. It's enough to know you came. So while you're losing your mind, won't you make some music? Try and understand.
Yuppie Scum!
In my house, it's a nice house full of bugs, but they're nice bugs. Don't you squash them, that's not cool, unless you want to turn into a bug. People walk around and they don't talk to themselves, but you know they talk to themselves. I know they do. They just think no one's watching. It's okay to speak nonsense when you're alone. You can get old if you want, but don't you lose that spark. You can get old if you want, but don't you change. There was this guy in jail named Dog. He would scratch himself and bark, just lying there on the floor acting like a dog. I said to him, "What's up, Dog?" And he just went ahead and kept on lying there acting like a dog. What do you know? I had a habit of sleeping with old ladies with no teeth. I'd buy them crack and cigarettes. They would steal from me, have people try to beat me up. It was beautiful. I wonder where they are now, those homeless ladies of Oakland, California. If you see them, tell them hi. And guess who's back in town?
I'll be there in a minute.
You can get old. You can get old if you want, but don't you change. All the bad ladies are crazy for me. All the bad ladies are crazy for me. I was walking over by the overpass by MacArthur, and I saw me a cat with a limp. Now I figured I'd buy a trap and try and catch this feral cat so I could get it proper medical attention. I caught all kinds of animals, mostly possums, and spent all kinds of time rooting around in the bushes. The moral of the story is it's okay to be nice, but it's not good to be too nice, because then you just start acting plumb crazy. I wouldn't do that if I were you. All the bad ladies are crazy for me. All the bad ladies are crazy. All the best.
thought maybe telling you about some of my experiences could help you see your situation from another perspective. I'm seeing in the problems between you and Sylvia a replay of the same hell I put Anne through when we were first living together. You don't talk to anybody about your problems with Sylvia and the baby. We hear the screaming through the apartment walls. More than once, you've seen her moving out and her baby's things, only to return a week later. And this morning, I saw in her bed a suicide attempt, the latest result of her desperation. You work at your tedious job to support her and the baby. You can't go out with your friends without their interrogating. You wish you'd quit hassling her and leave you alone. What's she got to be so desperate about? Well, it seems to me she's been screaming it constantly. I don't want to stay home all the time, she says. Home alone, all day, in a midtown loft, taking care of the baby. A repetitive, never-ending, but hardly full-time activity. No other people around. The baby is difficult to go anywhere and do anything. And Sylvia long ago stopped trying. She deals with the boredom by compulsively overfilling the needs of the baby in the house. And she is going crazy. Can you any longer see Sylvia for who she is? Remember how she used to be? Sexist society dictates that she give up her own identity and interest upon marriage and motherhood. And you make sure this does in fact happen by refusing to live in a decent place, by your control of all the money, and incredibly, your refusal to allow her to pursue her singing career. Not to mention your constant subtle undermining of her confidence and self-image. You create a situation that you claim that Sylvia's a drag on you. I guess you are demands are high. She wants you to be responsive to her. She wants you to be open so she can relate to you. Two things. That's all she wants. She can accept nothing less. And let's hope Sylvia can remain strong enough not to accept anything less. It's painful seeing her trust in other people and her trust in herself being destroyed. She is going crazy. How could she help but go crazy when it's such a difference in her life? Before marriage, she had relative freedom, numerous friends, interests, and plans. Now she is virtually enslaved by you, the baby, the house. She's unable to pursue her friendships and interests and is losing her sense of self. Far from getting constructive help in dealing with this problem, which many married women have, she gets indifference and hostility from the one adult she's close to. No wonder so many women go insane or commit suicide. But you convince yourself that her needs and demands are irrational, that you can't be expected to relate to this crazy hysteric.